Let us pray. Today, Almighty God, we have gathered to give recognition to the spirit that made our country great, a willingness to give totally of ourselves, even into death, for the great blessings of being a part of this country, for the honor and example of Staff Sergeant Romesha brings to our lives, we give you thanks. He was lent to our Army for a few short years. We were deeply blessed by his presence. As his ancestors inspired his service, may he inspire generations to greater service and devotion. In your strength, may we protect others. In your providence, may we be kept safe. May we turn our hearts toward you each and every day. We ask this and pray in your holy name. Amen.
Well, thank you, everybody. Most of all, thank you for Clint and the entire team for their extraordinary service and devotion to our country. We're going to have an opportunity to celebrate, and there's going to be a wonderful reception. I hear the food around here is pretty good. I know the band is good, and Colin really needs to get down. So enjoy, everybody. Give our newest recipient the Medal of Honor a big round of applause once again.
Colin, the little son of Clint Romesha, who's obviously very precocious, very excited, and emotional ceremony of the Medal of Honor, only the fourth living Medal of Honor awarded for a member of the U.S. military fighting in Afghanistan and, I believe, Iraq as well. Jake Tapper is here. Jake, you wrote a powerful book on this struggle in which Clint Romesha played such a critical role, and we see the president now meeting with some family members of those who didn't necessarily make it out of that battle. Your book, The Outpost, An Untold Story of American Valor, tells this story. What do you think? And you spent a lot of time with Clint Romesha. Jake, tell us what you think was going through his mind as we heard all of these words.
Just one other point before we get to that. The president right there saying hi to the son of Justin Gallegos and the daughter of Josh Kirk, two men who did not make it back. The White House making a point of making sure the president would meet the children of the eight men who were fallen. But to answer your question, Wolf, Clint Romesha has been all weekend very uncomfortable with the attention. He is not one who seeks the limelight. He is the quintessential soldier who talks about how he did this for his buddies and he didn't do anything other than his job, and he still is haunted by the eight men who did not make it out of Combat Outpost Keating. So he understands and recognizes the importance of this ceremony in American history and military history, and also how important it is for the other men of Black Knight Troop to see their experience acknowledged by the government and appreciated by the government. But he's not a big fan of all the fanfare for him.
It looked like at one point